Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Today's episode of The Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by our bonus packages. Please go to MikeO'MaraShow.com and click on the bonus banner. You'll get access to all of our bonus content, and even better, you'll be helping out TMOS. So please, quit sucking, and we thank you.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's The Mike O'Mara Show.
God almighty. Really?
Hi, how are you?
Anyway.
Well, it's so hard.
Happy Friday.
It's so hard. It's so hard to get everything ready. I am so unprepared. I'm so woefully unprepared. There we go. Now we can see everybody. Now I can see all your pretty faces.
Hi.
Welcome to the Mike O'Mara Show cocktail party. Can you turn that light up a little bit?
Oh, God.
Oscar wanted it darker. It looks like we're... I look like Bela Lugosi.
Mike, you look right here.
Is that a little better, Shannon?
I'm actually running the video. Shannon's not doing anything except answering phones and eating candy.
Is Shannon in a different... Is Shannon in a different spot tonight?
Yes.
Yeah, new shot.
She
new
set
shot.
Up a... I actually... I'm very angry that I had to figure this out, but I set up the phone screener on the same side as... the board and you guys.
Are you more comfortable this week? Are you more comfortable?
My cables are better. I solved my own problem, and that's sad.
And Santos is asleep. Santos is so happy with the good vibes that your dog is asleep.
Can you see him?
I can.
The Spiewak's shot is phenomenal tonight. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Although I hear a little...
Well, we're a good-looking pair.
I hear a little bounce back. I hear a little something.
You hear
but
bounce
I don't know
back
what
on
that
your
is.
End?
Yeah, I do.
I'll mute Shannon.
Well, hold on. I'll get it right. Let's say hi to everybody. Hi, Carla.
Hey.
Welcome. How are you
Happy
tonight?
Happy Friday.
How's it going?
Well,
good to see you.
I'm getting used to this mic stand.
All right. Very good.
Thanks can for you, sending that, Shannon.
Can you all You're still welcome. Hear me?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Good. Hi, Shannon. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you? You guys look
I'm
like you
wonderful.
Had sun.
Yeah, I got a lot of sun today. A lot of sun down here in Florida. Oh, hello,
so
Carrie.
Yeah.
Hi, Michael.
How are you doing? We're having fun. It's the Friday show. This has been...
What happened to the music is my question.
Yeah, what happened to your music, Rob?
I always fade it out before it gets to the blaring horn part.
Oh, okay. All right. Very good. Well, we're
back
here.
Up. It's really awkward.
It is a. It is another... I'm just trying to see if my mic's right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There we are. And we're all ready to have a little fun with the Mike O'Mara show tonight. And... my car is long gone. It's official. It's
sad,
no longer.
Right?
I said that yesterday, but today it was really official when they paid off the note on my car, and I realized it no longer belongs to
it's
me.
Over.
And you should be very happy. Another one of my many possessions that you have been systematically selling and getting rid of since we got married today.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
Yeah.
The day before. That- last month. Oh, champagne, Rob. Was that Prosecco?
No, this is actually champagne. Louis Boulot.
Oh, Brute. Then I know you didn't buy it yourself.
No, this is from the shipment that Dirk sent 2 weeks ago. We're still working on that.
Wow.
So Dirk sent how many bottles of champagne did Carrie, is that your beverage of choice? Like when you're gonna have drinks, do you prefer champagne? Is that what you like?
No, I really like it, but I'm usually simple in beer or
But champagne.
She associates it with special things, like champagne on Christmas morning is a big deal in the house.
Yummy.
So
that sounds almost like.
And I usually don't have a bad hangover afterwards.
Really? Did you have a bad hangover last week?
And the week before.
The week before
was more just my face hurt.
Yeah, because you fell on your face.
Oh my god!
Apparently.
Yes. I 2 weeks so ago. Which was the debut of Carrie, and I got excited when she was here on the show for the whole time. I was drinking the brown and got really, I had a bad hangover on that Saturday morning. It was not fun. But here we are. How much things have stayed the same this week? In my opinion.
Oh, really?
You might
be,
yeah, no change.
You might
no
be,
change.
You might be hearing people talking about opening things, but they seem to be dangerously the same and maybe even a little more dangerous when you are hearing, as of our airtime, The press secretary for the vice president, Mike Pence, has tested positive for the coronavirus. That is in the belly of the beast. That is in the middle of all of the action in the West Wing, setting up microphones, making sure people are going where they're going to go, and watching a CNN report right before we came on the air. I noticed that the reporter, White House correspondent Jim Acosta, was masked for the first time doing his report with the mask. So, you know, and down here, it was funny. I said, I'm not sure if I'm going to go to a restaurant anytime soon. And one of my buddies said to me, well, you can't tell that. A lot of people here have already been out to restaurants. So there's a group of people in this country that are, you know, if it's legal, they're going to go out and they're going to do it. So we're, I don't know. How do you guys feel? I feel as though we are still living in very uncertain times. I really
know
feel
that
way.
I'm very comforted in the state of Virginia when they're using science, because what our governor said today is we're not going to flip a switch and open everything. It's more like a light dimmer.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah, when
I said
slowly
he's
pushing
really
it up.
And it's really not committing to anything.
I like that.
I think that everybody is rushing everything. As a matter of fact, I've wanted to play this for you, Mike, all week, and I need to play it now. A salute to your great hometown that you used to live in.
Manassas.
Devil Town.
Exactly.
Manassas hole.
They have been really advertising on all the networks up here a big event this weekend. And I guess it must be necessary. It must be essential because it's going on before the 15th.
Be advised. This is a once-in-a-lifetime chance to save 40 to 80% on a hot tub and swim spa. Friday through Sunday. Millions of dollars of factory direct 2020 inventory. Prince William County Fairgrounds.
Oh.
Over 100 hot tubs on display and everything must go. See the revolutionary swim spa. You can exercise, swim, and relax without the expense and maintenance of a pool. Hot tubs starting at $29.95.
I don't want to give them an ad, but
if you're into hot tubs,
opened
it's
up
a steal.
But they've opened up the fairgrounds before they're supposed to open anything. The fairgrounds.
Well, it's Mother's Day weekend.
Yeah.
It's Mother's Day weekend. You know what? If you want to know my relationship with the city of Manassas, Virginia, all you have to do is rent the movie or get it on pay-per-view or put a DVD in of the movie, the classic comedy Animal House.
Yes.
And my relationship with the city of Manassas going into the purchase of my restaurant was the relationship that Otter thought, no, not Otter. Who's the other guy? Who's the guy that's coming? Boone. My relationship, thank you, Rob. My relationship with the city of Manassas and the people of Manassas is exactly the relationship that Boone has with Otis Day of Otis Day and the Knights.
That is so great.
Right, so you imagine that I am Boone in the movie Animal House, and Manassas is the Dexter Lake Club.
Right.
And I walk in and I go, there's Otis. He loves us. And the look I get is the look that Manassas gave me.
Yeah.
Collectively.
Yeah. Which is why 7 years ago you said we should be leaving. What a good idea.
What a good idea. Let's be leaving right now. Thank you for doing that, Carla.
You're welcome.
So, yeah, what was your feeling, Carla? You lived there with me during those happy, sometimes happy, sometimes sad times. What
you know, I'm really happy to be out of Devil Town. However, we did have really good times in Devil Town.
Oh, we had some
friends,
parties.
Yeah, great parties.
Yeah. You know, and it was
great parties, great drinking and smoking and staying up late and drinking bottles of wine and watching Red Sox from our outdoor patio, right?
Yeah.
It was sweet. It was wonderful.
It was so much fun.
Oscar backing up the toilet.
With paper towels.
That was, you know, I need a lot of paper. Mike,
remember when we cooked the snakes?
Oh, the cobra, the lion.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
We had some lion.
Lion and cobra.
Yeah,
there was no lion.
Python.
There was python. No, I think it was rattlesnake.
It was rattlesnake.
And there was lion.
And there was zebra.
No,
we didn't have lions.
No
I'm telling
lion,
you,
Oscar.
There were some really rare animals that we took care
and also
of
there
grid.
Was. I remember that show. We also ate the flesh of the non-believer, and it was delicious. Mostly, it was the sauce.
It was fun. I hate my light.
Yeah, I think
Carl looks good.
It looks like you're
flats.
About to be taken, Mike, back to the mothership.
Right. I know what's going on. Shannon, let me ask you a question. How are you doing now that you really have had time to get situated? You look lovely, by the way. And,
yes,
thank you.
What is going on? What is your position comfortable? Are you going to be better this week? Are you mad at Pony again? What's going on?
Well, I mean, I'm mad at Pony because I had to solve this problem, and I shouldn't. I'm not the tech guy.
Mm-hmm. Well, you are now.
I am now, apparently.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's been like 8 weeks.
What did I say earlier, Shannon? You have to be grateful. Be grateful that we have the opportunity to sit in these studios together. Right? Isn't it something we should all think about?
You're messing up my vibe.
It's great that he says that and they're not in the same studio.
And you're cutting your head off.
Are you putting on hand sanitizer or are you just doing hand lotion?
Yeah, something you could have done before the show, maybe, and not distract our entire
this
audience.
This is why I'm so cranky. He's such a monster.
He's a monster. Yeah, but when we had him share, here's the background on last week's show.
Right.
Rob and I were raked over the coals for, apparently, there were people in the audience that felt that we were disrespectful towards our wives.
Right, right.
And Rob getting mad and saying, Carisha! And I was saying, Carla!
And I expect that this
and
time,
then I
too.
Said, and then Oscar like tipped it in. And said, yeah, well, I can understand that. And then I said, oh, yeah, but we know the text messages that you were sending to Shannon. And then Oscar went in and he read his text messages to Shannon. And Shannon, they were firm, like
curt.
Sit closer, smile, act like you're having a good time or something like that. But they were not
stage
in
direction.
What I would describe as difficult or mean.
They were bossy.
And they were bossy. They
were direct.
Bossy.
They were curt.
But it really seems that the two monsters last week were Robin and Mike. That's the way
so
I look.
So between
it.
You two, though, who's who,
little
are
closer
you,
to
are,
the microphone,
are you the
please.
Bossy one, Oscar?
I think it's
between us.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, look, I'm the president.
I can
and she's
tell.
The vice president. Mm-hmm. That's just the way we have it structured.
Right.
You know what I like?
Struggle.
What's that, Carrie? What did you say?
The way Oscar has it structured.
Bingo.
That's his way of doing it. It's a clinker. Anyway, here we are, and this is fun because this is the mellow portion of the show when everybody's. This is just like being the first three couples at a cocktail party.
Yes.
When,
right.
You know, the party hasn't. There you go, Carrie. That's the key right there. That's what we're looking for.
It's some more.
Clinker.
Only one bottle this time.
Well, for the
really?
First show.
Yeah.
We have
yeah.
a second
bottle
standing by.
Don't make promises you can't keep, people. That's what I say to everybody about the drinking. Now, I have to point out that earlier today, in fact, probably less than 2 hours ago,
what?
I wrapped up a match with my mates down here in Cocoonville out on the golf course. And
right?
because they broke us up into two groups, in order to wait for the other group, we had about an hour between the two groups, and we sat in the parking lot, and everybody got their own beer. And everybody had beers. So I would probably be the only one in this group now who has done a little pre-gaming.
Oh,
I've had
right.
three beers, followed by dinner with a Diet Coke. I think the last beer I had was probably 2 hours ago.
Are they like Miller Lights or what do you
Miller Lights, okay. light beer. But
that's,
I still want to point
you,
out that if that I have a base, and I also probably have a little premature hangover myself, and I'm trying to correct
Ooh.
That as we
oh.
speak.
That's
well,
a, what is that, Mike? Why are you
looking at your phone?
You should take a shot.
Why are you
if
looking
you have
at
a little,
your phone?
If you have a little hangover, you should start with a Ooh. Shot and then continue drinking.
Can I ask why you're looking at your phone?
Oh.
Are you looking at your phone like you normally look at your phone right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, I'm kind of looking at what people are saying.
No, don't worry about those animals.
Let me see it.
Really,
yeah,
don't worry about that.
No.
That's not going to make you happy. That's not going to make you happy. She is addicted to her cell phone. That's the way it goes.
Are you
too
drinking?
You know what, Mike? You're right. I am.
Rob
disgusting.
Was speaking right at the moment
you
started
what?
Speaking.
I will do better with that, Rob.
Okay, because
I'm
if
so
you pay
sorry.
Attention, you'll know what's going on. That's all.
I'm just curious.
And I'm trying to be as nice as I can and not disrespectful.
I love you both. I love all of us. And are you guys having the same cocktail tonight? And if so, what is it?
This is poison. Rat poison.
Rat poison.
Distilled down. No, this is gin and diet tonic.
Gin and diet
okay.
tonic.
Nice.
Love it. Love it. Love it.
I'm staying with vodka this week, but I was out of grapefruit juice, so I made a game time decision and went with a grapefruit soda. Mike, how about a Fresca?
How about a Fresca?
Wow.
Yes, the world famous grapefruit soda,
like
Fresca. Oscar,
old
have you
school.
Decided maybe to shake it up, or is it still the old scent? Oh, there's a reason you're friends with Todd Moore. Now I understand. Yeah. It just, you know, it's the same. No experimentation. Yeah.
It's the chicken nugget of cocktails.
That's not
it's
true.
The chicken. It's the chicken.
A winner.
It's the
This guy's a winner.
It's the that is the best. It is the chicken nugget of cocktails. That is it. It's the McNugget of cocktails.
It is. It is.
Jack and
Diet.
Fair enough.
Jack and Diet.
Fair enough. Have you ever thought about maybe experimenting a little bit? Trying something a little more exotic?
Tangray and tonics when I was younger.
That's nice.
See, that's very elegant.
But then I would get mean, so I stopped doing that.
What?
That was smart of you.
Yeah. I think a college girlfriend said, you get mean with Tangray. I was like, cut it out of my life.
You know, it's true, though. You know why Hitler didn't drink gin? It made him mean.
Made him mean.
That's right.
That's an old joke. That's an old joke.
Shannon. I just killed Shannon.
That is made him mean.
Never laugh at Hitler jokes.
She loves Hitler jokes.
Oh, no. That's true. We discovered that Shannon likes Hitler. And Carla does, too. It's
good. Better than
come over to my house when all this is over. I can do a great show and tell.
I used to realize that breathing made me mean, and so I tried to stop, but I couldn't. That's really the way I look at it with all that. So anyway, it's close to us still, this corona.
Sure.
And I asked the guys,
I think
ladies.
It's over. No?
You think it's over? It's,
soon as they announced the NFL schedule, Mike, it was done.
By the way, are they when they announced I didn't see that today. I just heard about it that they had announced the NFL schedule. Mm-hmm. My question is, are they going to assume they're going to be putting people in the stadiums? Is that the way they're? It's going to be a full schedule without fans.
I think most experts say they are assuming without fans.
Yeah, if there's games at all.
If there's games at all,
that's what
they've already
too.
Canceled the games overseas. There won't be any of the games in Mexico or London that they've been playing the past few years.
The Jaguars.
Well, it's not a contact sport, so.
What is the status? What is the status of the kids in Leesburg and public school and your daughter going back to VCU? Where is all of that? She's not going back. We found that out last week, right? She's not going back.
Well, we've discussed the gap year. We're thinking about it.
If the gap is open.
There has been nothing determined from VCU yet. Now, keep in mind, she wouldn't be going back until August anyway. So this is, I mean, it's not necessary to make a decision today. We've not heard anything from the county as far as homeschooling continuing past this year, but Robert is in the throes of finishing his year. Mm. If he were to think ahead and plan ahead, he could be done in a week, but
Pony
he won't.
Pony wrote me a text.
Pony wrote a text while you were answering. Sorry, Rob. Paul.
That's all right.
Sorry, Rob.
Yes, yes, yes.
So
you
shall
got
see.
It, too.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Pony said, the new, more loving Mike is testing well.
Oh, that's good.
Give it time, Matthew. Give it time. No
Welcome
problem at all.
To the new sound of the Mike O'Mara Show.
We asked you what you wanted, and you said, don't be such an obnoxious prick. So we listened, and we decided we'd move on. You're awfully quiet, Carla. This is the tough part of the show. This is when I don't need the help. This is when you could just jump. What?
You told her not to talk when other people were talking.
I don't need any of your gasoline poured on this fire. Do you understand me? That can come later. You don't need. Yes, is your. Oh, you
see,
were.
See, I'm damned if I do, and I'm damned if I don't.
Shock jock.
Boy, that was tough. Okay. You want to try that one again?
I'm damned if I do, and I'm damned if I don't. But I do have to say, we never asked Shannon what she was drinking.
What are you? She's drinking LaCroix.
Same thing.
Oh, okay. And just so you know, I picked up some key lime, that stuff.
LaCroix.
Very good.
Nice.
Yeah. Loved it.
Have you tried
it? Good.
Yeah.
Tasty.
Yep.
I thought you said it was like rat poison.
Oh.
It's okay if that's the truth. That's fine.
No, it's not the truth.
Not lying.
I was doing what you guys do. I was just trying to cause a little
stoke
trouble.
The fire?
That's what just a little bit.
Well, just so you know, we did play Trouble today.
We did play Trouble today.
He won. Mm-hmm.
But hey!
Finally. Rub his feet. Mm-hmm.
So I get to rub his feet, but I said tomorrow night.
Yeah.
So nothing for me. Anyway, so we're happy. We're all here. And
she
of
can
course,
rub your feet after you play 18, Mike.
That's it.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. And then on Sunday, Mother's Day, it's going to be Carbohydrate Day in the O'Mara household. We are extremely excited about a big carbo loading.
Yeah, we are going to do it right. So in the morning, we're going to go to Krispy Kreme. Get a dozen donuts.
I'll speak up just a little bit.
I'll have probably five,
You're
six.
You're so mellow right now. Wait till you get loaded in about 10 minutes.
And
I got a text from Pony. Mellow Carla is testing badly.
Oh.
Hey, I got a text from Pony too. It says, I like when Oscar pretends to read a phone that isn't there. You know you're in the shot, right?
All right, well, we've tried, and this is going nowhere, so we have to take your phone calls at 888-920-MORE. That's 888-920-6673, and then we have to start the show at a certain time. But let's take a couple of calls, and then we'll go to our first break. Let's try it. This is the Mike O'Mara Show Cocktail Party for Friday. Hello, who's this, and where are you calling from?
This is Chris Chagnon from Burke, Virginia.
Chris Chagnon. Now, if you were in France, would that name be pronounced Chagnon?
No, it'd be pronounced ta-ta-ta-ta.
How much have you had to drink?
Yes, sir.
Chris, what can we do for you?
Well, I just like to say I love the show. Mike, I love your shirt tonight.
Thank you.
That's interesting.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I have a question for Rob.
I'll entertain a question. Go, Chris Jungle.
Did you get paid for your NFL bet for last year?
Oh. Really not the time to bring it up we're all in sort of financial straits.
Did
so
you
no.
not get paid?
No.
Not yet.
Oh, Oscar, I thought you were paying him for that.
Well, we needed the checks to pay you, and I said once the checks came, pay yourself. Did you not pay yourself?
We never did that. We never said that.
Pay yourself.
All right, then
Shame.
I will.
Yes.
How much does he get? How much does he get for the bet?
I think he gets...
$1,800?
No, he gets $1,600. Like $1,600. Yeah, $1,600. Yeah.
No, it's more. Hey, Chris, let me ask you a question.
Thank you, Chris. I didn't know anything about this.
Pay yourself.
Hey, Chris, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Are you? You know, they said now today unemployment like rivaling the Great Depression.
Yeah. Exceeds it. Yeah.
Are you among the workforce? Are you still gainfully employed?
Yes, I am. I'm essential. I work at a gas station.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, okay. That blows that.
Yeah, thank you.
I was hoping you'd say you were like a senior VP or something like that. So I would imagine you're not taking home a tremendous amount working at the gas station. Do you own the gas station or are you just an employee there?
No, but I am the general manager.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah. Well,
how much for a set of radials?
Yeah, could you cut Rob a little check or something like that just to maybe meet me halfway on the no? Okay. All right. Just check it. Well, thank you.
You guys.
Thank you for nothing.
Thank
sir.
You. Thanks a lot.
Rob,
appreciate that. Yes.
Pay yourself in installments. We'll talk after the show.
Fine. We'll work
Did
out
you
a lovely plan.
That guy, though?
Not at all.
Right?
Not at all.
You won the bet.
Best
you deserve
caller
the money.
Ever.
You won the bet. You deserve the money.
How did thank Rob you. Win $1,800?
Rob had the best picks every week. Rob had the
wow.
best pick.
Is
Rob,
it seriously
Rob, you want it going?
$1,800?
Yes, it is. Yeah. All right.
No, no, I didn't. I was actually in the last week. It was within three or four games of Oscar. It was neck and neck at the end.
Oh yeah, you sucked.
I sucked. Yeah.
That's right. It's coming back. It's coming back.
No, I mean I gas pipe sucked.
Yeah.
I couldn't pick anybody. You know, it's just like I was the one that was just going. Bengals? Yep.
You know how at the
Sounds
end of the
like
season,
a good bet to me. Yeah.
At the end of the season, when a sportscaster will say something like, "Am I the only one who thinks that the team can run the table and go to the playoffs?" At the end of the season, it would have required four plane crashes and COVID for Mike to win.
Mike was saying things like, "I really like the Giants' offensive line this year." Anyway, it didn't
Gosh,
work.
Mike,
out
you are well. Such a loser.
Thanks, Carla. Thanks very much. And now we can start the show. It's going to be so much fun.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mike O'Mara, Rob Spiewak, Oscar Santana.
And now, from his easy chair, here's Mike.
We are live from the Podcast Village studios in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C. This is the Mike O'Mara Show, cocktail party number 12.
Woo! Eight.
What?
Eight.
No, we haven't done eight.
Yeah, we have.
We've done eight of them?
Eight.
Yes, this is the eighth
Wouldn't
one.
Wouldn't that be Nueve?
Ocho.
Oh, Ocho.
Ocho. On El Ocho.
B minus. In Spanish.
Yes.
Yes, sirree. And the valedictorian for Centerville High School is Carla Avetta.
This girl.
Anyway, from Alameda, California, Kalamazoo, Michigan, Nebraska City, Nebraska, Schulenburg, Texas, Yellow Springs, Ohio, Copenhagen, Denmark. Is that these? Is that this week's cities or is it last week's cities?
No, you're right. We'll have new cities on Monday.
So yeah. Confused. The show today brought to you by MyBookie.
Yes.
Hey, sports fans, racers, hot rodders. Sunday. No, that's a different commercial. Sports fans, big news. The UFC returns tomorrow. Can Tony Ferguson beat Justin Gaethje?
Yep.
Gagey.
Gagey, I know. Rob gave me like a lecture before the show started. A pronouncer. Everything. I'm going to take
it's
from
a
the
really
top.
Screwed up spelling. His name is weird.
All right, let me see. The UFC returns tomorrow. Can Tony Ferguson beat Justin Gaethje? Let me try it again. Here we go. I got it. This one I got.
Gaethje.
All right. Gaethje. Gaelic. Gaethje. Gaethje. All right. The UFC returns tomorrow. Can Tony Ferguson beat Tony Gare? No, I'm sorry. Can Tony... The UFC returns tomorrow. Can Tony Ferguson beat Justin Gagey? Do you want to make it interesting?
I do.
Thank you, Carla. Yes, real sports to watch and bet on. And if you visit our buddies at MyBookie and sign up and make a deposit, you can grab a free $49 bet on the fights. Your weekend just got so much better. It'll be so much fun to watch live sports.
Oh, God, yeah.
I'm ready for it in a fight, too.
Yeah.
Can I buy it? Yes. I love boxing. This is boxing we're talking about.
No, this is ultimate fighting.
Yeah, even better. Even better.
More violent. More violent, Carla.
Octagon.
You don't mind that, right?
Blood. They run around in boy shorts. You'll love it.
Anyway, MyBookie, sign up and make a deposit. It's fantastic. If casino action is more your style, MyBookie still has blackjack, roulette, slots, war.
I love war.
Yes.
And more.
I mean, not real war, but you know, the game.
War. Of the roses. MyBookie has live casino dealers online. That's right. MyBookie has dealers right there at tables. I've signed up. You should too. Visit MyBookie.ag. Use promo code TMOS for a 150% bonus on your first casino deposit. That's promo code TMOS to receive more than double your deposit in a cash bonus all the way up to $750. Use promo code TMOS to activate the offer. This is the weekend to dive in. MyBookie.ag. You spin, you win, you get paid. All right.
Indeed.
That was the first call. Trouble, nothing but trouble. And
right.
It gets worse and worse.
Not for
and,
me. Now maybe the clown will call back this week.
Chucko the clown. Yeah, you know, when you ask for him, he usually calls in. So let's dive in.
It's like rubbing a lamp.
Let's try another call at 888-920-6673. Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who's this and where are you calling from?
This is Andy from Aldi, Virginia. How are you?
Aldi.
You okay, remember out by, Aldi.
Yeah, out by Middleburg. How are you, sir?
Leesburg.
Good. How are you guys doing?
It's great. Middleburg. Thank you.
It would be the Leesburg area.
A little past Leesburg.
Oh, it's past Leesburg?
That's my South Riding.
South of Leesburg, yes.
What's the little town before Middleburg? What's that one called?
Washington, D.C.
Haymarket?
No. I'm talking about like on Route 50, when you're heading out to Middleburg, Virginia, there's a tiny town when you get right before. What's going on with your phone, sir?
I don't know. Sorry.
Okay. Yeah.
You better be.
You know. Hold on. I don't like to be difficult with the callers like right out of the gate, but you know exactly what happened with your phone and you're
lying. Yeah, don't be
lying.
A liar.
You're
yeah.
lying to Turn me. Tell me what happened with your phone.
I will admit that I've had you on speaker for the past 25 minutes because I've been waiting here with my daughter who asked to want to call you.
How old is your daughter, sir?
I have a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old.
Oh, nice.
Do they want to come on the show?
Yeah, my 5-year-old daughter, Isabella, we were riding in the car yesterday listening to the show yesterday, and she said, can we call Mike O'Mara? And I said, actually, yeah, we can tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, so we'll dial in. And she, at 6:30, she said, hey, Dad, it's Friday. Can we call Mike O'Mara? I said, absolutely, in a half an hour we can. So.
Aww. Oh, well let me speak to, which daughter am I speaking with?
Okay. Isabella.
Here, talk to Mike.
Isabella?
Hi.
Hi, Isabella. Oh. How are you?
Good.
What are you doing today? Have you been watching videos?
Yes.
Wait, have you been watching cartoons?
When it's not raining and windy.
Tell your daddy to stop coaching.
All you guys, I just want to thank you guys for this, for the, all the stuff that you guys do. You guys have been keeping me sane through this whole thing. I'm stuck at home the whole time, so you guys have been champions.
Yeah, all right. I don't want to hear about you. Put Isabella back on the phone, will you, please? All right. With all due respect.
Talk to him.
Hi.
Hi, sweetie. So what videos did you watch? Did you watch a cartoon today?
Put your dad
back on the phone. Put your dad back on the phone.
Yes, I'm here.
Are you there? Stop.
Yes, I'm here.
Coaching her.
Sorry.
I have a 6-year-old. I can handle this. All right, here we go.
Okay.
All right, this is Isabella, right? Isabella? Okay.
Yes.
All right.
All right, very good. Isabella, are you there?
Yes.
What did you have for dinner tonight?
Pasta.
What was that?
Pasta.
Oh, pasta. Mmm. Did it have butter? Was it buttered noodles or did you have tomato sauce?
Buttered noodles.
Buttered noodles. Mm. Big one. Yes, sirree.
Did daddy tell you how to eat it?
Isabella, do you love your daddy a bunch?
Yes.
Is your daddy funny?
Yes.
Oh, that's great. Well, you got a good day. Uncle Oscar wants to. Yeah,
Isabella.
T.O. Oscar.
Would you please blow some pepper into the phone? God. Please.
Yeah, would you like to hear Donald Duck sneeze? Isabella, okay. What I want you to do is blow into the phone and go, and you're going to blow pepper in my face, and then I'm going to sneeze like Donald Duck, okay?
Okay,
on the count of three, blow into the phone. 1, 2, 3, blow. Wasn't that great? Wasn't that funny? Look at Oscar. Look at that is it.
You know, make no mistake. The wife likes Hitler jokes, and he likes the duck.
All right, Isabella, sweetheart, put your dad back on the phone, okay?
Bye, Isabella.
Bye, Isabella. Bye-bye.
Hey, Mike, thank you. Thank you so much for taking the time and speaking to her. She was
you're a good guy. That was fun. That's my favorite thing to do in the whole wide world. Thank you very much, my friend.
Can I say one more thing?
You bet.
All right. When we dialed in and got up the video, my wife came over and said, oh, my God, is that Carla?
Oh, okay. So, yes, this is Carla. Yeah. She's right here.
Yeah,
she didn't know what Carla looked like before, so.
Carla, so I take that as a compliment.
I like your shirt tonight, Carla.
Oh, thank you.
All right, pal. Thanks a lot. All right, thank you very much. Okay, horn dog. All right,
come back. Yeah, I try. Yeah, you can call anytime.
Yeah, go make another baby, all right?
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, pal. Thanks for calling in from Aldi.
He should stifle. He's a helicopter parent that needs to just pipe down.
Yeah, I agree.
Let's take one more phone call. So I'd love to try to stay on time tonight, but it'll never work.
Hello.
Oh, shush. Being on time is no fun.
Mike O'Mara's show, Cocktail Party, with... Rob and Carrie and Shannon and Oscar and Carla and Mike, and we're all here. Who's this and where are you calling from?
Mr. O'Mara.
Yes. Pause.
Hello. This is Juan. I'm one of Oscar's people here in Helena, Montana.
Oh, that is exciting.
Fantastic.
And that Montana, we never get calls from Montana.
Yeah, that's
exciting. I love that.
I've been trying for what, 4 weeks now?
Wow.
That is exciting.
And you finally made it through. Congratulations.
Yes, I did. Thank you.
So I believe Montana, you are extremely spread out in that state, and I think it's legal to lick doorknobs in the state of Montana. Isn't it?
Yeah, kids are back in school, right?
Yeah.
No, well, the kids are not back in school, but the whole doorknob licking, I think that's next week.
Okay. Next week with that.
Okay. Fair enough.
So Montana is seriously not... as affected, or what's the status of your state? Because I never pay attention to Montana when I'm thinking about the COVID.
So, Mike, we're very fortunate here in Montana. I think we have about 458 cases, and unfortunately we did have 16 fatalities.
Oh, no.
Wow.
God. It's amazing when you think about the cases in my county are more than yours. Oscar, the cases in D.C. Are crazy right now. Cases. It's just
I always think about Montana. I always want to visit Montana.
I'd like to go. That's on my list,
like,
too.
It's called the Big Sky State, correct?
Big Sky State,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Isn't, isn't that where Letterman used to escape to? He has a place there, right? Isn't that
I think
the
so.
State
I think that's where he hangs out.
When this is all over with.
I'm sorry?
No, go ahead. I'm sorry.
I was going to let Rob know, yes, he does have a place up north, north of Great Falls.
Okay. Mm.
You guys don't pay your taxes, right? That's what I heard.
Yeah. But no, I just want to thank you. Thank you, Mike, for bringing the funny. You, Rob A., Oscar, and the spouses,
thank you, sir.
For these shows. I work for the local hospital. And you just thank you for bringing the funny because it's such a relief to listen to be distracted, you know.
Oh, that's awesome! Yeah, because even in Montana, the whole country's dealing with
no speed limit
crap.
In Montana though, which is fantastic.
No, that's a lie. Stop it.
That was years ago, Oscar. That was back in '99 when we called it reasonable and prudent.
I remember that.
Reasonable and prudent. What did you say the total number of cases in the state of Montana are?
458. Cases
in the state.
16 fatalities. Yes, sir.
State. Okay.
That's where we need to go.
Just in case you wanted to come and visit, I think it'd be a great time to come down to Florida, where there are only 39,199 cases.
You should seal the border, sir.
Yeah, yeah. But it's okay. Only 1,669 deaths.
Yeah, that's it.
That is so weird. I mean, in my county, I'm looking at it right now. They do it by the darker the county, the more significant it is. Total cases in my county, where I live, 1,219 with 62 deaths in my county. If you happen to go over to the Miami area, Miami-Dade, 13,664 cases with a total of 468 deaths. Mm. But
they're opening the state.
But if you look at the curve, I mean, and I'm looking at it, it does appear to slowly but surely be going down in that direction.
Some more good news. I got a chance to catch up with my brother yesterday. I mean, look, for what it's worth, things are the curve is people are still getting sick, still dying, but not at the clip and rate, at least in Massachusetts, that they were before.
Good. So the question will always remain with the states that open up. We'll see in two weeks, three weeks.
Hopefully it's still down. That would be nice.
I really do believe for those people, and you get a lot of people, a buddy of mine said tonight when I mentioned, press secretary of the vice president just got diagnosed and said, and they said, I'm sure you're happy about that or something to that effect.
Hell no.
I think anybody, no matter what your politics are right now, we just want this to go away, get back to normal and see if that happens. But stay safe out in Montana. By the way, we've been flapping our gums. Is there any reason you called? You just want to say hello?
I want to say hello and just that my wife and I are enjoying, actually, it's now become a ritual. We watch every, weekend on Friday and That's we sit sweet. Down and enjoy a GTO and watch the show. And I just want to say one thing, Miss Carrie, superstar.
Yeah.
She's a superstar.
Yeah. And, I will tell you one thing. I'm getting Oscar, you can probably pipe in on this. I'm just getting Carrie, I know that you are an independent spirit, and I know you you do whatever you want to do. So, listen, I'm not sure if I could devise a signal that would indicate that he's preventing you from really cutting loose this week, but you just do whatever you want. Yeah. Okay.
I would like for her, before she really comes, let all the bruises heal from last week so we have a nice baseline.
They weren't bruises that were a result of your behavior. No, those were her falls, right? Yeah. Was that what it was?
I think it's about time for a break, isn't it?
Yeah, let's take a break.
They drink and fall a lot, it seems like.
Yeah,
Rob said, great, now everybody's going to think I hit you.
See, that's a little ray of sunshine right there. We'll take a break. Come back with more of the Mike O'Mara Show. Thank you, Paulie. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by wow, really? Really?
I put a double shot in there.
Did you really?
I did.
I've done 1,000 Cornerstone commercials in that one, seriously. And that one started. This portion of the program brought to you by Cornerstone First Financial. During this pandemic, Cornerstone First Financial
has emerged. Why am I doing Tom Brokaw? I don't know. Cornerstone first fight.
Do this guy, that guy with the teeth, the rock.
Oh, the guy down here. So oh, there's him? A guy down here. All right, Cornerstone. I'm hijacking your time right
they're
now.
Game, they're game.
It's fantastic. 202-625-1221. Mark Livingstone.
Wow, Mike, are you losing
I'm
it?
I'm fine. I've had a long day. 202-625-1221 or cornerstonefirst.com. Great people. There is a guy down here that does a dental implant commercial.
Yes.
And he is, and this is Carla and Michael's favorite impersonation that I do, because he... The commercial is they gave implants to the guy that claims he discovered Prince.
Right.
And so he goes, so he comes on and he goes, huh, hello, I know a little something about this guy. I discovered the rock star Prince. And then and they talk about all the stuff they do with dental implants. He goes, make sure you see Dr. Latigati. He's a rock star. And Michael loves it.
And then the guy comes on, the doctor.
Yeah, the
and
doctor
he
comes
talks,
on and goes, that was a very good commercial. No, I am a rock star.
He talks the same way. They like the teeth are too long or something.
And I can eat corn on the cob.
They love corn, man.
Call
and
Cornerstone
you can't say
First
Cornerstone
Financial.
Without corn.
That's right. Cornerstone can give you the best. Cornerstone First Financial can give you the best dental implants you've ever
no,
gotten.
Mike.
Come on now.
They'll give you the money to do it.
Finance your implants. Yeah. Well, they pretty much do refis and home mortgages.
Well, either way.
That's pretty cool.
But anyway, they're nice. Call Cornerstone First Financial for all your lending needs. No matter what you need, Cornerstone First Financial does it all. They are rock stars. 202-625-1221 at cornerstonefirst.com. See what they can do for you. Cornerstone First Financial. Personal attention from application to closing. I discovered Prince. You can count on him being a rock star.
Because really, because he discovered Prince, that means that he knows good dentistry? I mean, really, what's the connection?
He searched around all around the world, and he found this guy,
because
just like he did with Prince.
He has a good eye.
A good eye.
Just not the eye to determine that he will someday need dental implants.
Because he never brushed his teeth.
Oscar.
Mike, you know how our wives all disrespect what we do for a living on a regular basis. And it's such par for the course, I think, for anybody that's in broadcasting or radio overall, right?
Right, right.
And... I had a sweet moment, and you don't have many of them, so you have to highlight them to the team and our families here.
Okay.
Yesterday, after the show, you cut a bunch of reads and spots, like promos.
Yeah, there's a couple of them coming up, actually.
Yeah, and Shannon was in the control room, and she raced to put the headphones on, and she said, what is he doing? I said, because we were uploading the video after the show. That's what we do. I said, he's doing these live reads that Rob writes, the scripted that go in between the shows.
Yeah, Rob writes them and I do them. Yeah.
And she said, and then she's sitting there and she's like, he's doing them in one take. And I said, that's what makes him a genius. He can do them in one take.
Oh, that's sweet of you to say that. That's fun. I mean, you do enough of this stuff.
If you really want to know about the disrespect afterwards, she actually got on mic and said, Oscar said he does those in one take. Is that true? Because she didn't believe him. I said, yeah, but you know, and what it has to do is that it's so much fun to write for you. And if I can hand you something that's in the voice that you know how to do it, it's always one take. Unless
it's nice to have this discussion right after that Cornerstone debacle that I just had, where I was trying to do that.
But we had an amazing session yesterday. The only thing that tripped you up was the word Walter Mondale.
Say it, Mike. Say it three times fast.
No, it's just that's a little in-joke between me and him.
Rob will write stuff, and I'll try to get through. Usually it's the Larry King bit where I'm saying King's things, where he just says stuff, and there'll be something in there that inevitably I can't go. I can't read it because it's too funny, and it can be absolutely simple.
Stupid.
It was the dumbest thing, but it was just so perfect that Larry would say that. The as far as doing commercials, and I've done voice work for forever as far as doing spots as well as doing a radio show, and I would have to go back when I was in Washington, D.C., and go to different studios if I would be lucky enough to get a gig to do a radio commercial. And the worst, the all-time worst as far as doing a voice again And again,
oh, no.
I don't remember her name, but I know I remember her company. The it was the lady that was, I think, the senior vice president or the president of Shoppers Food Warehouse. And I auditioned and got the voice of the top quality tomato, which I was very proud of because it was animated and it was a TV commercial. It ran in D.C.
Yes.
You know, hey, look, I'm not, you know, you got to take
what
it where you
line?
Can get it.
Hey.
With top quality prices every day.
Yeah, but what was the voice?
That's not the voice.
No.
With top quality prices every day. And so I went in to do this, and just they used to do radio booths for recording that would be, you'd go into like a basement.
Yes.
Yeah.
It would just be like a regular empty industrial room, and then they'd
one little booth.
The carpenters would put together this tiny little booth.
Sound
and it's
booth.
It's a sweat box.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it was the middle of the
no
summer.
No ventilation at all because there's no venting in there.
There's no ventilation.
Why
at all.
Did they do that? Was the
for
sound
perfect
good?
Sound. Because, I mean, really.
You can't have
most,
AC on while you're recording.
Why are you making the money sound?
Because
why
it's cheaper to just put you in a refrigerator box, which is essentially what they've done. If it was a room to code, it would have to have a window or ventilation or something. But what they put them in is one of these. Yeah, it's like one of those glass bulbs that they're putting on Japanese beaches. So, you know, just sweat it out.
And I go into this thing, and that the reason I remember that's the size of that booth, 47 takes.
Why?
Because the line that I gave Oscar was with top quality prices every day.
Right.
And at first it was like, well, can you emphasize prices? So I go, with top quality prices every day, which is not a bad read.
Right.
But then after you're at number 36.
Say it with a smile.
That's right.
That was the direction. Oh, did I, you know, it's like.
Can you emphasize
top quality
in,
prices every day? Yes, it was. And she was the, and it wasn't like I was working with a producer or a radio person where I could go, excuse me, you know, I got to go eat.
Yeah, I'm the talent. I'm the talent.
You could be a little
Shut
more
up.
Of a diva, but this is the, and by the way, when you would do a commercial and they said, now the client's coming in today, just welcome to hell. Welcome to hell. Now, the other big commercials that I did, I was a ripoff of a furniture guy that you heard all over the country. I wasn't the guy that you heard all over
I
the
remember.
Country. I was today, for 3 hours only, this sale
guy.
Will be tomorrow night. It was that guy.
Marlo?
Yeah. Marlo
I
Furniture.
Remember him.
They didn't want to create their own brand. They wanted me to rip off the Marlo guy, which is really kind of what my entire career is based on.
Well, you also did President Barack Obama for Jerry's.
For I did Tony Soprano.
I'm sorry, Tony Soprano
for Jerry's, but you also didn't you do for was it American Service Center? You did a fake Morgan Freeman.
No. American Service Center hired a guy that was a bad Morgan Freeman that did that.
Oh, that
was another guy.
I got the details mixed
that
up.
That was another
yours
guy.
Yours would have been better.
What was the Jerry's one?
Oh, the Jerry's was great. You recorded that in Philadelphia when we were on WYSP.
Yeah, Jerry's was a big sandwich chain, you know, and
Jerry's Subs and Pizza.
Jerry's Subs. Yeah. Ooh, Jerry's, and they were dicks. Yeah. They were just dicks.
But
they
what,
were.
What was the character? What was the line?
I did a bunch of different impressions. They always had impressions on Jerry. So, hi, Linus. How are you?
Happy.
Yeah. Jerry's didn't let me do Bill Clinton. Yeah, I remember that. That pissed me off. They hired another guy. Wasn't as good as me. Yeah, it pissed me off. That's why I hate him. And then, Sorry, Linus. We're discussing Mike's failed career. That's what we're doing
now,
right
but
now.
Shannon's discovery that, like,
Did I do it in one take?
You do it in one take. She didn't believe. She ran over to Rob, put on the headphones to ask him, why would I lie about that? That
makes sense. But really, she did want verification.
That I did it in one take?
Yeah.
True, Shannon. True.
Just don't ask me to do it. Don't ask me to do a Cornerstone spot in one take or any other commercial. Especially the one coming up, which we're going to do like next because we're up on a break.
Actually,
we
I
have
was,
to take a break.
I was wondering, can you beatbox?
You mean, huh?
Yeah.
I just did all I can do.
Okay. Hey, Mike, Disorderlies, rated PG.
Disorderlies, rated PG.
I knew we could.
We'll take a break. That was a nice,
I'm going to go make another drink.
That was a nice little trip down Ego Alley for me. I enjoyed that. We'll be right back with more fun. That's going to stop soon. Too much niceness. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, this portion of our program brought to you by Best Fiends. Yes. Now I have pressure to do it in one take. If you're looking for a fun way to pass the time while engaging your brain with great visuals and a gripping story, your answer is Best Fiends. Best Fiends is a casual game that anyone can play, but it's made for adults. You can spend as much or as little time as you'd like in the game, perfect for a little break anytime. Yes, Rob Spiewak.
Mike, I am at level 55. It is called Icy Peak. I have no trouble gathering the raindrops, but I can't kill the boss slug. But I'm staying with it. This is an addictive game.
I dated a girl between my first and second marriage that I named Icy Peak. It was a long story. It's a wonderful game. Best Fiends, a unique and exciting puzzle experience unlike any other. Best Fiends updates the game monthly with new levels and events so it never gets old. Best Fiends is great at a time. It doesn't require internet to play. Internet. So you don't need to worry about Wi-Fi access or using cell data. No bandwidth, no problem. Spend some time with your Best Fiends. Engage your brain with fun puzzles and collect tons of cute characters. Trust me, with over 100 million downloads, this 5-star rated mobile puzzle game is a must play. Download Best Fiends free on the Apple App Store or Google Play. That's friends without the IR, the R.
Without
I didn't
R.
get through it in one take.
You got so close.
You said
I
IR.
I felt pressure because Shannon was watching me do that. Best Fiends. I blew it.
Shannon. You got his mojo and you wrecked it.
Story of my life. That's when the pressure's really on. When the pressure,
Shannon,
really
you're a monster.
On.
How dare you? A psychological monster.
No, she's a Volkstar. let's take some more phone calls,
please.
Shall we? Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who's this and where are you calling from?
My name is Daryl Boggs Gillihan, and I'm calling from Lee's Summit, Missouri.
Missouri.
Wow, I love
Missouri.
These calls
That's
from the
great.
Heartland. This is great. This is wonderful. I have a soft spot for Missouri because the guy that bought my house was from Missouri. So hello,
oh, wow.
My show me state friend. What can we do for you?
Well, first let me say what I'm drinking. I am drinking a Two Pitchers Brewing Company Nordic Jam.
Nice.
Made with Nordic berries you can eat.
That sounds like something you wouldn't drink. That sounds like something you put on a piece of toast.
Sounds delicious.
It's really good.
That does sound good.
What I wanted to call for was, I wanted to apologize, Mike. I'm one of your silent listeners. I haven't called you since the Don and Mike days.
Wow.
But I wanted
long
to apologize because, yeah, way back then I ended up following Don, and I realize now what a big mistake that was. And I I failed to see you as the real talent.
I agree, Mike.
No.
Hey, it's kind of like a backwards compliment.
No, no. It was, you know, the thing is, though, you don't negate that much time with, you know, decades, 20-year partnership where many, many big checks went into the bank. And, you know, the thing that where Don was brilliant, and I mean brilliant, was his ability to recognize trends and to know what was hot and to know how to get on a subject and just have a sixth sense of what would catch fire. And I knew a lot of people in the business. I knew a lot of people that did that. That was something where he could be 3 weeks ahead of something that he smelled was going to be really,
Idol.
Really hot and popular and just ride it and do well. And, you know, I mean, it was we did well. We had a lot of fun. It was crazy. It was meteoric. We had a lot of fights. We had a lot of good times. And, I wish it would have been happier times. I do. I look back. That's an honest answer from me. I look back at that. But in this business, in any kind of show business, imagine if you had people that had interpersonal relationships that were complicated on a movie set, but they had to do that movie 5 days a week. It gets difficult sometimes. And, you know, but you can't. If I'm going to sit there and poo-poo those years or say this or that, I appreciate your compliment. But the fact is that I wouldn't have been allowed to do what I do without the talent of Don Geronimo, and I mean that.
And I think he was wonderful because he was a Virgo.
Ah, that's right.
And I am, too. Yeah.
Now, that was a drunken night, if I remember correctly. That's it. But I appreciate that, but I don't like to, you know, look back, and I appreciate what you said about me being able to do what I do. I love what I do. This is way too much ego stroking for me on this show. I'm not comfortable with it.
I can actually, about that foresight, you're actually right, because when I went and saw him in Sacramento, I went with my then-wife, and when we walked up to him and talked to him, pointed at me, said, "I love you," pointed at my wife, said, "You, not so much." And now she's my ex-wife, so he was correct.
Oh. Wow.
See? See, I was right. I was right. Yes. There you go. Well, thank you, Missouri. Yes. Yeah, we appreciate the call. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Yeah, I feel like if we let that go, something horrible is going to happen.
All the really great broadcasters can sense a trend like Charlie Warren can.
Charlie Warren, one morning... Charlie Warren.
I don't know the story.
All right, Charlie Warren. Rob's talking about
the most vanilla.
Yeah, tell us.
A vanilla DJ on WMAL that Charlie did a Warren. Weekend show, and his great break would be, "Have you seen a good film lately? Call me now. Let me know." Is that kind of level
Charlie
of
Warren?
Creativity.
You guys are being mean,
Charlie
girls.
Warren. Right. Yeah. Well, yeah, Rob started it. Let's take another call. Hello, 888-920-MORE, 888-920-6673.
You're the critic.
You're the critic. Tell me about a film you've seen or a stage show or a local Johnny Holiday production. Hi, who's this and where are you calling? Where are you calling from?
Oh, Rob.
Hey, hi, it's you, caller.
Mac McIntosh.
What are you calling and come into the studio? We don't care if you get it.
Oh no.
He's high risk.
Well, yeah, no. I'm high risk. So I'm home.
That's right.
Wait. In all seriousness,
why are you high risk?
Because of your Addison's disease makes you high risk. Is that it?
Yeah. Oh, okay. And the autoimmune disease. Yeah.
It's autoimmune. Okay.
Exactly. Yeah. And it keeps touching everyone's computers at work. So I mean,
JFK had it. JFK had it. Mac, how are you? How are you? Driving your parents crazy?
Yes, and trying not to go crazy myself. It's just very lonely.
Oh, because you're non-essential. You can't go to Rent-A-Center. And no,
Micro Center is essential.
Damn it, I'm essential.
Just on leave.
To be fair, he really has been non-essential most of his life.
Hey, but
this is is this not one of our greatest intern success stories, Mike McIntosh?
God, gave him a life.
He has a banana nut bread, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does the banana bread.
He's the banana guy.
There you go.
He wears orange.
Mac, have you ever met Carrie Spiewak? Mac, shut up. Have you ever met Carrie Spiewak?
I have at a few events at Jimmy's.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, God, right, Jimmy's. Very good. I could go for some wings.
So, a Jot Burger.
Have you been to a good restaurant?
Jimmy's. Have you had a good wing lately? Mac, what's going on? Oscar has a question for you, Mac.
Yes, Mac, look. I know that you're on leave because your Addison's disease, it's chronicled here, and I understand that. And your parents, you live with your parents, probably not good for you to be in front of people as they are elderly and they want you out of the house and you won't leave. The real question is this. Do you still get the friends and family discount emails when they come in?
Yes, I do.
All right.
My account is still active, so it is fully working.
Nice.
Have you bought a good wire?
Wonderful. Hey, how you doing? By the way, with my battling of the weight, I don't have Addison's disease. I have Dolly Madison's disease.
What? The bakery.
Mac, is there any particular reason you called? Or you just want to say hi?
I just wanted to say hi, check up with you. It's been like a month since I've been there, so I just wanted to say hi to you guys.
He wanted human contact.
God bless you, brother. God bless you. Are you doing anything different now with the COVID, with the shutdown of all the getting out and about? What are you doing at home? Well, I think I'm, I can, bro.
Wait, what's he doing, Mike?
Games.
I have a direct question,
Jesus.
Mac. I have a direct question.
Yes.
Just out of curiosity, sure. I know you're probably staying perhaps in the basement, away from your folks. What is the last meal you ate?
The last meal I ate was actually we ordered a leftover Chinese from last night.
Oh, I'm so jealous. Okay. We have no good Chinese in the state of Florida.
I've got a question.
You sound like Donald Trump.
I've got a question. Mac, when's the last time you beat off?
Oh, stop that. We were all making the joke in you now.
Right
Oscar
before he
that.
Called.
Thank you. You don't have to answer that, Michael. You don't right have to now. Answer that.
Well, please do.
Stop, Carla, what's wrong with you? Oh,
I mean, a question was asked.
All right. No. Go ahead. Go ahead. Answer the question. Go ahead. Answer.
Be honest.
It would be about 2 nights ago.
That's a lie.
Oh, you see.
2 hours ago.
Yeah, I had during the Montana call.
I'm doing it right now.
2 hours ago. All right, thank you. We got to take a break. Bye, Michael.
May peace be with you.
Love you. Love you. That's great. Oh, God. Ooh, no. Ooh. I'm not going to sleep after that. We'll take a break. Come back with whatever. What? We'll
what? Come up, banana we'll come nut back bread. With,
my mouth's not working. Today.
Jesus, Mike, get it together.
Thank you. We'll be right back on the Mike O'Mara Show. This portion of the program brought to you by KiwiCo. We're seeing a lot of kids stuck inside lately. How have you checked on Michael?
Yeah,
lately?
He's fine.
Yeah.
He's all
TV.
Good.
He's a Max yeah, house.
He's playing his game.
All right.
We're Minecraft.
Stopping now.
Love it.
Yeah.
If you think it's impossible to get a kid to put down the cell phone or video game and do something that's good for their brain, you're wrong. Is there a chance we can get KiwiCo to provide something for every day instead of the monthly package? Because
I actually
love it to
was
be
in touch
day.
With them this week and explained that there are dire circumstances in the state of Florida and they need to accelerate their provisions. And
thank
they're
you,
working
Rob.
On it. No problem.
I'll tell you, awesome. The Kaleidoscope package that came in was an entire afternoon. It was fantastic. Yeah. This is really, really
and Michael
great.
Was so proud of that.
He was proud of it. It's a science and art based. It's a science
Jesus,
and art based.
Mike?
It's a science and art subscription box for kids, tested by kids. It's more fun than any game they can play, and it was truly surprising how much we both enjoyed it. I love the thing. Michael loves getting things in the mail. He loves doing it by himself, mostly, and I loved helping him. It was great to spend quality time tackling projects together. Each box has all the supplies needed for that month's project. Why are you patting me on the
good
shoulder?
Job,
supplies!
Good job, good job. Surprise!
All you need is an appetite for fun, like I'm having now.
Have you got a good project?
KiwiCo
yeah,
is.
I babysit a kid who does these Kiwi things. They're
isn't
so
it great?
Cool.
It's yeah. very yeah. cool.
They're
it's great
really,
stuff.
Really cool.
Helping.
They think them through. That's wonderful. KiwiCo redefining play with hands-on projects that build confidence, creativity, and critical thinking skills. There's something for every kid or kid at heart at KiwiCo. Get your first month free on select crates at KiwiCo.com/TMOS. That's KiwiCo.com/TMOS.
Damn, boy, that was
thank
good.
You. Thank
yeah, you
thank
go,
you.
Girl.
Where the hell am I in the show? I have no idea.
And you know what? If you mess up again, you're going to have to take a shot. Mike. Okay.
We have one more commercial break that we need to get in
we
before the end of the show.
76 minutes. We're okay.
Right,
we need to take some calls.
Yes, she
what do you think?
And it's the 66th minute, not the 76th.
Excuse me, I'm hammered.
Yes. Why don't you take a call, Carly? Go ahead.
Oh, yeah. Oh, can we have a call, please?
No.
My favorite part of the show.
You don't say, can we have a call, please? You
I
have
say
to,
whatever yes. I want to say. If you give it to me, Carla. I get to do it.
You have to identify to the caller who's
hey, listen. You asked me to take over. I can do it. All right, Shannon, can we have a caller, please? Awesome. So we have a caller on the line. Who are you? What you drinking?
Hi, I'm Emma. I'm from Rochester Hills, Michigan. And I'm only 13, so my mom's only allowing me to drink Coke Zero.
That's awesome. What a great mother.
That's
and
awesome.
By the way, I do love Diet Coke and Coke Zero.
Yes, it's good stuff. What's your name?
Emma.
Oh, I'm sorry. My wife was talking to you.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm sorry. So, Emma, so you're calling. Is there something that you would like to talk to us about?
I don't really know. I'm just bored. So I'm watching the show.
That's why I'm here.
Yeah, we are too. We are too. So that's perfectly fine. So you say you're 13?
Yeah.
Awesome. What grade are you in?
Seventh.
Okay, and you're doing like learning online?
Yeah.
Okay, and how's that going?
It's going pretty good.
Okay, and who's your mom?
Her name is Jennifer.
Okay, yeah. And she's a listener?
Yeah.
Awesome. Tell us a bit about your mom, being that it's Mother's Day on Sunday.
Yeah, she's very, very sweet. I love her so much, and she's
aww.
Very pretty.
Aww.
Oh, that's so sweet.
You're a good little girl.
Hot mom check. That's awesome.
Can we give a prize to Jennifer? Is that possible?
Absolutely.
Do we,
absolutely.
Do we have
absolutely.
The capability yeah, yeah. of doing
100%,
that?
100%, Mike. 100%.
Put Jennifer on hold. And Jennifer, I want to send you something because you're so sweet. Can we do that for you? Maybe send something for your mom, like a T-shirt. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. What is that?
Oh,
Rob?
A deck of cards.
Send a deck of cards.
No, no, we have t-shirts. We have t-shirts. We can send some.
Rob.
I'm just checking with what I got.
Rob, the listener's friend right there. Send her a deck of cards. They got a plastic comb. There we
air
go.
Horn.
Will you please get that info for us, please?
Thank you. Worked with middle schoolers for 2 years, and they're awful, but she is so sweet.
How sweet,
that
right?
That is 13 years old. Not awful. You're absolutely right, you know. Yeah. That I remember middle school as being.
So when you met Carla, sorry. You had to wait. Oof.
So Linus heard that air horn and came running like there was trouble, really? Like mom had fallen again.
Yeah.
Speaking of middle schoolers, let's bring a kindergartner in here for a second. Come on in. Come on in, Michael.
Oh, there he is.
Come on, there he is.
Hey, buddy.
Here's your microphone. And put your headphones on. Put your headphones on. Watch out. Here, put your headphones on. Okay. There you go. All right, watch out for the... That's why we don't... Okay, hi.
Yeah, just
say
water.
Hi to everybody. All right, say hi.
Hi.
Hey, buddy boy.
How are you?
Good.
What have you been doing?
Playing Minecraft.
Any pigs?
Would you like to tell anybody about Minecraft? That would be exciting.
Well, I keep dying and dying and dying.
No,
and
you
dying.
Don't. You build a whole village yourself.
No, that was in creative mode.
I know you were in creative mode, but it's still cool that you built that whole village by yourself, right?
And I built a Viking ship and a destroyer.
Did you
hear
the latest news about Minecraft, little Michael?
No.
So the campus, if I'm not mistaken, of Stanford University, really important university, has been built in Minecraft so they can virtually graduate in Minecraft.
Oh, that's cool.
They're going to graduate from the university in a Minecraft village or something like that?
So a replica was built in Minecraft.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Can't you talk about the? Can you just tell them about the villagers that you you gathered the villagers and brought them from the Viking ship to the village?
Yeah, it was very annoying because they kept getting in the water and I had to keep doing it over and over and over and over.
Did you get them all over there eventually?
Yeah.
Yeah. And what was the thing you were telling me that literally you were somewhere today? Literally something happened.
I don't know.
You don't remember?
No.
Okay.
What about Mother's Day? What do you got planned for Mother's Day?
Yeah, what's the plans?
What are we going to do for Mom? What? What?
I don't know.
I don't know. Hey, Michael, come here. Come here.
I don't either.
All right. There you go. That's good. All right. Love you, buddy.
Hey, I
love
just got
you.
This from VCU.
Bye,
VCU.
I love ya.
VCU is doing a virtual graduation with the game Centipede. You have to use a trackball to graduate.
Oh, my God. All right, let's take another phone call. Hello. Oh, did we get the girl's information and all that? I didn't forget that, did I?
I think she did. I'm not sure.
Are we cool with that, Shannon? Shannon's
Emma, call back or right email now. Us if you have to.
All right.
Rob, okay. With 2Bs at Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's take another phone call before we have to break here. Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who's this? And it's been a very controlled show. There's a certain segment of the audience that'll like that. Me, I like a little more brawling. Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who's this and where are you calling from?
My name's Kevin Winter, and I'm calling from Lakeview, Oregon.
Oregon!
Oh, my God.
I love Lakeview, Oregon.
I'm calling from Lakeview, Oregon, and I have 15 people in my crawl space beneath my cabin. I'm just kidding, sir.
I'm wearing clown makeup, and I'm calling in.
I'm at the top of an osprey's nest overlooking Puget Sound. Okay, that's not even in Oregon. Hello, sir.
Okay.
I don't know where it is. Hello, what can we do for you, my friend?
I just want to thank you guys for staying on the air ever since COVID started. My job has become 1,000% more stressful as a reporter at a small-town newspaper.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah, at least you got one. I mean, so many people don't right now. It's very, very frustrating,
sir.
You know. So,
but your show is wonderful as it provides an hour of fun after a day of misery.
Oh, my God. That's so scary right there.
That's really not great praise because the show is 80 minutes long. So he's saying that 20 minutes of it, not so much, but an hour is pretty good.
What's your beat, sir? What's your beat?
What's your beat?
I'm the only reporter, Oscar, so my beat is everything.
Oh, wow.
What is the most significant story you have covered in your journalism career?
Our county commissioner has served for 20 years, not running for re-election.
Love it. Love it.
Well,
love it. Love
crowd
it.
Loves that one, sir. Oh, I'm sorry. Come on. Give him a break. Give him a break.
You know what's great is Oscar really asked him the same question he asked Mac. What's your beat?
What's your beat? Exactly. Well, in Oregon, we appreciate it. Hope you're enjoying the show and keep up the great support, okay,
go
my friend?
Go Goonies.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye. There you go. That's an interesting call there.
Never say die.
Hi, Swindy. What are you doing? Are you coming over with your drink? All right. Very good.
It sounded like you were talking to your son.
No, it's
well, she's a lot younger.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for pointing that out, Carrie. I appreciate that. Hey, Rob, that's a good time to go to a break. I think the tide has turned. I think officially the show is moving into its second phase.
Phase
right
two,
now.
Mike. This would be the act three of a Shakespearean tragedy.
DEFCON.
By the way, Carrie, lovely camo look tonight.
Yeah, I like that.
I like the camo.
Wait, you can see me?
I can see you. Yes, I can. Yes, I can see you.
She's one of the original Riggo's Rangers.
I love those two guys. Anyway, let's take a break, and we will come back with more fun and more thrills on the Mike O'Mara Show. Welcome back.
Mike,
I love that.
You so killed that one. That was so good.
Yeah, yeah.
You wrote it. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by our bonus packages. Hey, folks, thanks for joining us tonight at the TMOS Cocktail Party. We love our Drinking McDrinkerton drink-along shows, and you know you're having a great night when you and your buddies hit a second location. So let's do it. Tonight's second location is the TMOS bonus show.
Nice. I love second location.
Right?
Did you just blast a burp during that Bill Clinton?
I didn't burp. Somebody did.
Oh, was that somebody
was
burping?
That was Carrie. This Carrie.
Oh, was that Carrie's burp?
Yeah.
She's a lady. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
She's a lady.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa, she's a lady.
Bryce,
let's do it. TMOS bonus show.
With the new.
It's another episode that streams free of charge. That was a beautifully mic'd burp right there. Free of charge. I know you put a lot of effort into that promo, and I did it. We recorded it yesterday, so I was really interested. And then I was looking over at Carly going, why did you belch? Rob was telling me like he loved putting that together. Oh, my. Anyway, we provide the second show as a free service, but after it streams, it hides. It goes away and goes hidey boo boo. Yeah,
it goes behind the.
Yeah, it goes behind a naughty paywall, so make sure you snag it. Also, remember, there are 500 other commercial-free uncensored bonus shows available to you for just pennies a day at MikeOMaraShow.com. So, a subscription might do you well. It's your passport to...
Mike? Yeah,
Passport.
Copyright 2020 PMO. In vito veritas, the wine lies... In wine lies the truth. Right, Oscar? The TMOS bonus show, because the truth is hard to swallow, but cocktails are not. Hail Caesar! I don't know what was on your mind last night.
May I make a request?
Oh, yes, go ahead,
please. Would love an Assport graphic for a possible T-shirt.
Oh, the passport to the Assport.
Yes,
love
passport
that.
To the Assport.
Wow, that's going
Please.
To open up. Well,
Please.
Right now, do you hear that sound? That's the sound of the TMOS Pinup Appreciation Society.
No.
Just getting all really excited.
Something people could wear without being too embarrassed.
Okay, I'm going to make this request. If we go with it, yes, but nothing visual as far as a pictorial representation.
No.
And a very friendly
like,
font.
Maybe
please.
Like a passport that's being stamped with TMOS, something like that.
That might be nice, yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but you got to, if you're going to have passport to the Assport, you got to have something ass related on
it. Well, I agree, but it could be a little subtle, right? You have to look for it.
Yeah, I mean, if you're thinking Assport.
Yes.
All right. Passport is the easy part of the T-shirt.
Yeah.
The Assport, however, is going to get you in trouble.
Carrie, what do you
like
think?
If you go out.
I think the O in passport could be like a butthole or something. Be cute.
That's why she's a star, ladies
There are
and gentlemen.
No wrong answers That's when Carrie. We brainstorm.
Carrie Spiewak. The O should be a hole. The dookie hole. The bad part where the poop comes out.
The bad
That's
part.
It.
Exactly, yeah.
Absolutely.
Sphincter.
Carrie.
The balloon knot.
Oh, my God. Shocking. That was so incredibly shocking. All right. We have time for maybe two more phone calls, and then we have to roll it on over into the bonus show where there are no commercials.
We're not
and
stopping. We're going to kill
straight
through.
By
yeah,
the
quick
way,
promo, and,
Carrie,
and then boom.
Is that the first bottle of champagne that you are finishing right there, or what are we?
Yeah, I don't know.
She's been gauging herself pretty well, but there's a second bottle in the fridge that she can get during the break between the two shows.
It's not that I'm trying to get your
break.
Wife drunk.
That
it's just
threw me
you
last
know,
week.
She did the butthole joke. I think she's probably right on course.
She's absolutely on course. Take one or two more calls. Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who's this and where are you calling from?
It's Charlie Burney calling from
Charlie, I am so thrilled that you are supporting us and listening to this show every week, and we hit you at the right time, obviously. How are you, my friend?
Well, I'm finishing my bottle of scotch, Mike.
Oh, wow.
Are you? Are you now?
It's Friday time. Good time.
Wow.
I have a question for Carla.
Yes, go ahead.
Hi.
Carla, were you in the chat room? Were you watching Justin Trawick the other night? Do you know Justin Trawick?
Oh, actually, yeah, I did. He was live, and they were beatboxing, and I was listening for a little while. Yeah, he's awesome.
No, he's a great friend, and they just covered him yesterday on CNN.
Yeah. Right, I know, I saw that. That's local artist. Yeah, I didn't see the CNN bit, but I did know that.
Because I'm in the dark and I want to know more about it.
Is a local artist, and we've had a connection to really the Michael Mara show. Friends with friends with him. Charlie's friends with him. Katie Forbes Von Herman's friends with him.
He's Manassas based for a while, wasn't he?
Yeah, I thought so. He's a local guy, and he is doing what everybody's doing. They're trying to.
Do I know Justin?
Reinvent themselves.
You think you're friends with him? I mean, he's friends with the whole Mike
Mara
show,
familiar,
really.
Yeah, I think I've known him maybe
white
for
guy.
A while.
And oh, the white guy.
Yeah.
Well, good.
Oh, the white guy that lives in Manassas.
Yeah.
That's the one.
Yeah, the white devil.
Hey, Charlie, can I ask you a question?
Of course.
Can I get the brand of scotch that you are enjoying this evening?
This evening it's Johnny Walker Black.
Ah, Johnny Walker Black.
Out.
Okay,
look
that's
out.
It.
Yeah.
So do you drink it on the rocks or neat?
At the moment, I'm iceless, so I'm drinking
Ooh.
It neat.
Yeah.
Oh, drinking
nice.
It neat.
Nice.
Ooh.
Yeah, I tried
Let
that.
It breathe, baby.
Now,
it
is that with or without a cigar?
Without.
Oh, okay. No. Okay.
Boy, I hate me some cigars, boy.
Mm. What are you channeling your job you used to have at the Playboy Mansion? What's going on?
I'm just trying to get a vision. I'm thinking, ooh, a little scotch neat with a cigar sitting on my deck or in front of a fire.
You get neat on the rocks. You having a cigar? Can I interest you in a cigar? Cigar. Cigars, cigarettes, Tipperellos.
There we go. Charlie.
Dead soldier in Leesburg. Right, dead soldier in Leesburg.
Charlie, also a fantastic artist, has sketched everybody on the show. And we love his sketches that he does of the show. You rock, Charlie Burney.
You guys take care. Bye.
Miss
Bye.
You, Charlie.
Bye.
Love you. See you at the Pod Bar.
Yeah, Rob, is that the is that it for the regular show, or do I have time for one more call?
You all, there's always time for one more, but if you were to end now, it would be just fine.
Yeah. That means I'm going to take one more call. One more call. It's gone so well. And so smoothly.
Oh, God.
Seamless.
What could possibly... Oh, don't even say
I
that name.
I think it's Dennis Murphy.
Don't say that. Hello, Michael Mara Show.
I'm killing myself.
Who's this and where are you calling from?
Hi, Mike. This is Ken from Sacramento.
Oh, hi, Ken. How are you, my friend?
I am fine. How are you?
Doing great. What can we do for you, sir?
I would like to hear everybody talk up some records.
Oh.
That's tough. That is tough.
We could possibly do that in the bonus show as we roll into that.
All right.
Yeah,
I'll tell you what we're going to do.
Great.
All right, well, you know, we can try that. Rob, you've got the capability of doing it where you are.
Yeah, absolutely.
Any specific song, though, that the listener's looking for?
Well, no, I mean, I think he just wants to hear talking.
Some Prince.
Ooh, okay.
A rock
star. 1999,
party
maybe.
Like it's 1999.
All right, hold on a second. I'm just looking around here.
What are you drinking, by the way?
I'm drinking beer.
Yeah,
like a real man.
I like
beer,
that.
Yeah, boy. Hold
sure,
on.
Sure, boy.
Sierra Nevada Pale Ale.
Right. How many have you had?
Ugh. I'm on my third one right now.
Oh, okay.
Pacing
right.
yourself. Respect.
Oh, here we go.
Did I hit that or did
go.
You? Hey, I guess I did. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the regular portion of the program. Coming up in just a couple of seconds here, we're going to cuss. And for our friend out in Sacramento, I just want to tell you, it's going to be a lot of cussing. Carrie's going to tap into that second bottle of champagne. And Katie, bar the door.
Hand me down the walking cane.
Thank you for listening, my friend. Oh, he's gone. All right, so anyway.
Shannon.
That's it. Let me
trigger.
Turn that off. Yes.
She's out.
Trigger, he's out. Shannon. Trigger, yes. Did you all have a good time on the first part of the show?
Oh, fantastic. I feel like it's the calm before the storm.
It is. That ends now.
I have the hurricane.
We have to get out of here. It's time to go. When we come up, we're going to have one more hour of uncensored
We're not going anywhere,
content.
By the way.
We're not going. It's free,
we'll be back
so
in
stay
a minute.
With us. We'll be back in 1 minute, and that's the way it's going to roll. And if you got a problem with that, well, I'll tell you how I feel about that when we come back. And I'll tell you in no uncertain terms. For Carrie and Shannon and Carla and Oscar and Rob and Pony and Maddie Masiello and everybody associated with this wonderful crew that we have here. This is, what?
I'm giving a thumbs up.
Really?
Yeah. What, did you think I was flicking you off?
Yes, I did.
Never.
We'll be right back with lots more fun. Look at my hair. Doesn't it look great? We'll be right back, everybody. Before.
Before you go, please make a mental note. Today's show is made possible by the TMOS bonus packages. You can secure yours right now by going to MichaelMarishow.com and clicking on the red bonus banner. Buy it or give it. Either way, you're helping out TMOS, and that's a good thing. Thank you, and go in peace.
Thank God it's Friday!
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Just trying to have a little fun, folks, that's all.
Should I tell people that I am a good at sex?
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son.
We feel sorry for people who don't drink because when you get up in the morning, that's as good as you're going to feel for the rest of the day.